watching ERUDIRE PLUS, the professional CAD solution provider. This channel provides basics of finite element analysis and computer-aided mechanical engineering design and analysis using CAD-related softwares. Then let's get started.
Hello friends, today I'm going to explain the mechanism and analysis of a 4-bar linkage. It is also called a 4-bar. It is the simplest movable closed chain linkage, which consists of four bodies called bars or links, which are connected in a loop by four pin joints. Generally, the joints are configured so that the links move in parallel pins, and the assembly is called a planar bar linkage. We have already drawn these linkages. We have to take it and assemble right now. The models have already seen, so we have to start assembly. For assembly, we start from assembly part here. We'll take the parts. First one you have to take, part number one. Okay. Now this one to be fixed in default position. From automatic, we'll take default. So the color is changing, that means it is fixed. Green check, okay. We can provide some color to this one. Let's take the color of this one as blue. Okay, blue color is enough. Let's select the second object. We have taken the second object, that we have to bring it close to the left hand side. Again, feed view. This one you can rotate a little bit. Okay. We have brought this to close side by side. Now we need to have pin connection in between them. So from user defined, we can select pin. So this surface should be mating with this pin. One constraint is filled up. Now second constraint, that means this edge should be mating with this edge. This is done, right? We can rotate a little bit. This is done. First part is done. Now green check. We have to draw the second one. We have to bring the second one. Okay. Let's find some different color to this one. Let's take this one as red color. Okay, done. Next part we have to bring the third component, part 3. Okay. You can bring this close to the part, and here also it will be pin joint. So from user defined, you select pin, and here hole should be selected. Here also this pin should be selected. Next part, the surface, top surface of this one should be mating with top surface of this one. Done. We can feed view, we can see by feed view, it is complete. Now we can rotate if you like a little bit. Done. Now select the last component, assemble. Okay. Feed view, let's bring it close together. This one will be here, we can drag it a little bit. This way. Okay. Pin joint is required between these two. So from user defined pin, this pin should be selected. Feed view, here pin is required. Okay, now this surface is required. That means this surface should be mating with the top plane of the pin. It's done. Now one thing is remaining, the last connection. So at this point we should not take the green check. because one connection is still pending and same time we have to provide two connection. So we need a new connection. It will come from placement, new set, and this pin connection. So pin is required. Can do a little bit of rotating. Now pin is required. This pin should be selected and the hole. This hole selected. Now the surface is required. Surface means here it will be top face of the pin should be meeting with back face of the link. Done. Drawing is complete. The modeling part is complete. Right. Field view. Now we can clear all these different sections, all these different planes, axes, etc. Drawing is complete. Modeling is complete. Before that, you can give different color to this part. Maybe you are putting green color to this member. Modeling is complete. Right. Okay. Next part is we have to provide servo motor at this lower legs corner, right? Okay, this is fixed and this one will be rotating. Let's take the mechanism part. So we start from analysis, applications, mechanism. Servo motor to be provided, servo motor, and we need to take the velocity. So axis need to be changed from meter millimeter per second to degrees per second. What we'll do, we'll select the location where we have to provide the motor. At this point, at this location, we have to provide the motor, servo motor. Now let's check the profile details. Angular velocity units degree per second, and we need to provide the values of angular velocity. Let's take this 50 degrees per second. Okay, angular velocity provided. Next part is we have to start mechanism analysis. The name of the mechanical analysis is analysis definition 1. We want dynamic analysis, and let's take the duration for this one as maybe 30 seconds. And frame rate 10. Now while going for dynamic analysis, we have to see the motor location, okay, motor starting. And the external load should be applied, that is enable gravity and enable all frictions, then run it. So the mechanism is running perfectly. Okay, now we have to make a video of this mechanism that will come from playback. Starting the playback, and frame rate we can increase, by the same time we can increase the speed also. Let's run it. It's running very smoothly. Okay, let's stop it and capture it. That means video will be made. Now here video formats, we are having MPEG format. AVI will take AVI format will take, and the image size is 640 by 294 pixels. Okay, so video is being formed right now. Video is complete. Now to find out velocity and acceleration of any place or any component. That will come from, that will come from its measures. Okay, we have already done this analysis definition one, that to be selected first, then we are starting velocity profile. Let's provide the name of this one as velocity, and position should be replaced by velocity. And which point we want velocity? We want to have the velocity of this point, maybe, right? Okay. It has found velocity is 132.58 degrees per second velocity at this point. By the same time, we have to find acceleration of the point also. So what we'll do is select this definition one, and instead of position, we'll take acceleration, and the location is the keyword location. Okay, we didn't provide the name of this one. Maybe we can provide the name of this one as acceleration. Let's provide name. Okay, we got acceleration equal to 113.60 radian per second square. Right, now we need to plot these things. First of all, we are plotting velocity. See, along x-axis we are having time, and y-axis we have velocity of that point. It can be saved from file or export to Excel also. That will generate a lot of data. Okay, next part we'll see acceleration of that part. Acceleration graph. This is a graph of acceleration. Along x-axis we are having time, and along y-axis we are having acceleration of that point. Again, that part can be exported to Excel or it can be saved. Now, if you want to plot both of them together, by control you can select both of them and plot. See, both acceleration and velocity is plotted together. We can have some kind of comparison in between velocity and acceleration from this graph. If you want to take both of these graphs separately, you have to click the graph measure separately here itself and plot. So velocity and acceleration are plotted in two different separate graphs. First one is acceleration versus time, and second one is velocity versus time. Okay, again the same thing, we can save it and export to Excel. Lot of data will be created if we export to Excel. Okay, now last part, we have to go for curve tracing. That means, suppose any point we take, it will show how the point is moving while this mechanism is running. It will come from analysis, trace curve. We have to select the mechanism. That is, we have already done analysis definition one. Now we have selected now the location we want. Select this point and preview this part. If you preview, it will show the path. So this violet color path is the curve tracing, right? Okay.